Hi friends, a very good evening to all of you and a warm welcome on madhurisluxury.co. Today we are here with a very interesting topic and which is also the call of the hour. International Yoga Day is on Monday, but we start celebrating from today, and Monday we'll be coming with episode two. So let's begin here with our episode one today with yoga. Let's welcome Luxury meets Yogini Mansi Mahajan and Arjun today here with us. Hi, Bansi.
Hello, namaste.
Namaste.
Thank you for having me. So nice to be here.
Pleasure and honor. And good to see you in such lovely surroundings. So serene and green. Nice.
Yeah, thank you. I try to
Goes
keep in
perfect
touch
with
with the
the
only way I exist. Hi,
yoga. Yeah. Hi, Arjun. Welcome on Madhuri's Luxury
Arjun.
Show.
Thank you for inviting me.
Pleasure.
So cute.
And before we start with the program, I would like to introduce Mansi to everybody. Mansi is an international yoga and wellness coach who leads global yoga retreats, transformational programs, and workshops. She facilitates workshops for corporates such as Adidas, Volkswagen, BMW, Shell, NIIT, and many others, both in India and abroad. She has touched the lives of over 10,000 people through her well-being modalities and sessions. A source of inspiration, Mansi is a Yoga Alliance certified instructor who believes that the need for practices that open our hearts and unite our spirits is more urgent than ever. And yes, it's even more urgent now, no doubt about it. She has launched her own school of yoga under the International Yoga Alliance and hopes to create and train yoga teachers that will be an invaluable asset in our world right now. She's a publicized author who has recently completed a series of yoga books for children. Mansi has been awarded Exceptional Women of Excellence by the Women Economic Forum. This is where we met 3 years in a row for extraordinary contributions in the wellness space. Yoga, meditation, and breakthrough with Mansi is a deeply profound experience of wellness while including creativity and soulfulness. Each session with Mansi is a harmony of spontaneous movement and a seamless celebration of yoga, philosophy, mantra, pranayama, meditation, and movement in a rich and heartfelt experience. Mansi is a visionary spirit with a deep devotion to soul alchemy. Her vision is to serve all beings and awaken magic into the world. And I'm sure we are all going to experience some magic here today with Mansi. And such a pleasure to have you, Mansi, with us here.
Thank you so much, Madhvi, for such a warm and generous welcome. I'm feeling very honored. I'm feeling very welcome. So thank you so much for having me here.
Pleasure. And let me give a brief introduction about Arjun to everybody.
Yes, yes.
Also in the Positive Support Initiative, I want to support and encourage youngsters with whatever they're doing, because they are going into unconventional things at these days, and they want to be doing a lot of stuff and totally different. So I would like to introduce Arjun Advani. Arjun Advani is a modern school pass out from Barakamba Road, and he's from college, Bhagat Singh College. He did his theater from Shriram Center and has performed in many plays at the Shriram Center and IIC as well, and other theater shows. So he's also trained in yoga from Bharatiya Vidya Bhavan and Sivananda Vedanta. Attended Osho Youth Fest at Zorba, basic meditation program at Art of Living. Learned 3 months chow from Triveni Kala Sangam. Currently learning yoga from Yogananda Society of India. So it's going to be a very interesting discussion today, and a lot of learning from Mansi. And as a youngster, Arjun will also tell his point of view and teach us a bit, and also learn from the mentor Mansi here with us. So Mansi, I would like to ask you about your personal transformation journey to be a yogini. You're called a yogini. I love the word yogini. So we'd love to know your journey.
Yeah, the journey's been pretty simple. Like I said, I always say best things in life are usually good accidents that happen to you by accident, right? So you don't plan these things. Like I'm a trained filmmaker. I went to film school. I did my master's in film production in Australia, and I had lots of different plans that didn't look like my current life. But like I said, it's life always surprises you in the best ways possible, given that you have the windows of your heart open. Otherwise it can shock you. But you know, I came back from film school, and you know, I wanted to, you know, there was a whole lot of other things happening. I started my entrepreneurial journey. So, you know, many years later, when I look back, even though I'm not making films anymore, you know, I'm happy with the movie of my life. I think the transformation started very young, because I started, you know, my mom brought, she used to take us to yoga when we were early teenagers, me, my sister and I. So I think that was really like the beginning that brought the texture of yoga into my life at a very, very early age. And for that, I'm ever so grateful. I think that is really, you know, that's what sets the pace. That's what sets the tone for what is to follow. And then I think another, you know, another aspect which I really want to offer credit to in my personal transformation, in my journey itself, is, you know, coming onto a spiritual path. So I think it was almost about a decade ago when I came onto a spiritual path, and I didn't know what was, how my life would go through this quiet revolution just by adding that drop of spirituality. You know, everything opens up. You don't even realize the potential you have as a flower to blossom, right? We're all living our lives as like closed, beautiful buds, right? And then one day something touches you in the way that it's meant to, it, you know, it reaches to your essence and you start to flower, you start to blossom slowly and exuberantly and vibrantly. And what you throw out into the world, it comes back to you multifold. And that's the whole magic of it, right? That's the whole magic of working with energy, working with yoga, working in the transformation space, that whatever you offer, it comes back to you, you know, in multiplicity of ways, much more than you can even harness. It's, you know, it's, there is so much abundance right at the core of it, right at the heart of this. So beautiful. Yeah, that's a little bit of the journey.
Wonderful, very nice. And I do see some connection of movies with yoga or movies with theater somehow, since I've seen my seen Arjun also pursuing theater and then getting into yoga and meditation as well. So though, Arjun, there's a long way for you to go, but still would love to know about you, that how did you get into yoga, since when, and about your little journey till now into yoga and spirituality.
Am I audible?
To Arjun. Yeah.
So we were doing this workshop, theater workshop, with Adil sir, Adil Hussain, and he mentioned that he was doing a workshop. He was conducting a workshop in Hampi, and there was a foreign participant. She had sinus and breathing problems. She could not breathe properly. So he did few exercises, breath work, with those group, and her sinus was cured and she was able to breathe properly. So I was really keen that you can cure yourself through yoga. And then I read the autobiography of a yogi. It inspired me to learn Kriya Yoga. So I'm learning Kriya Yoga right now.
Lovely, wonderful. And yes, we'll come to that topic with Mansi and both of you, that how yoga can cure so many of these diseases like breathing and stomach ache, headache, and so many other issues that we face in our life. And now to Mansi, I would like to know a brief about your yoga retreats, transformation programs, and workshops. What is it all about, if you can educate our audience and us about it?
Definitely. So, you know, I think we get so entrapped in our lives, we get so distracted with everything that's going on around us, that we forget that all that movement that we're engaged in, everything, all the activities that we're engaged in, the origin point of all of it is a place of quiet, is a place of deep stillness. And that exists right at the core of us, that exists right at the very center of our beings. And if we don't access that, if we go on with our lives, accumulating a whole lot of distraction, accumulating all that we do, you know, just keeping ourselves busy, like busy, being busy is such a, you know, it's such an excuse, it's such a fad, right? Like, I'm so busy. But if you don't create space, if you don't create slowness, if you don't take a pause, I think somewhere, something will start to malfunction. Somewhere you're over, you know, you're abusing the body mind connection, and you'll feel it. You know, it comes in, it shows itself in so many varied ways. Like, you might get chronic pains, you might start to feel the beginnings of some illnesses, some disease. The biggest blaring, blazing example we've seen is like the pandemic. What happens when we're always running and then we have to run so fast that we can run no more? So I think that's what happens. That was the idea of us going on these transformational awakening retreats, that, you know, you go in somewhere, you know, it's a digital detox. We try. We collect phones when we, you know, start the program.
That's a good idea.
It's important, right? Because that's, you know, we Absolutely. Need to break our patterns. We need to break our urban habits. And yeah. they're so deeply hardwired into our nervous system. So it takes a lot of knocking. So what we do with these programs and these retreats is that, you know, we just add a little bit of pause into our lives. That's what it is. It's just add a quality of slowness. You experience stillness within. You experience that inner quiet, because from that inner quiet, you know that movement can movement can originate. But when that happens, when you're operating from that place of inner stillness, it's conscious. Everything you do, there's a quality of consciousness then. And it could be, then you could be doing, like we always say, right? We're, you know, we're urban yogis. We're yogis and bhogis together, right? We're not living, you know, in Himalayan snow peak caps and, you know, we can, you know, leave the world behind. We can't do that. We need to do everything in balance. We need to do it in equanimity. So to be able to do that, you need to instill it in your daily life. So once you access that, once you access that, you know, the essence of you, it'll stay with you. Because I always say, once you ignite that fire, it's inextinguishable, you know, because that's you're saying hello to your inner self. You're saying hello to your true nature, which is very joyous, which is very abundant, which is deeply exuberant. And then when you go back to your life, you get back into your rhythm of whatever you're doing, you'll see magic, you'll experience magic, because, you know, everything comes with a quality of consciousness, with a quality of awakening. You're not doing anything blindly. It's not like you're blindfolded through life. You know, you're not multitasking 100 things at a time. You're not stuffing food in your face while you're like answering emails and WhatsApp messages. You know, you're like with that present here and now. Moment. You know, it's the intensity of the present, I always say.
Beautiful. Lovely. Very nice. We would totally like to attend this retreat sometime for sure.
I think we must do something together. Yeah, this is the time now. We know we're not here for very long now.
Yeah, true. So now I would like to come to Arjun, and I would like to ask you, Arjun, as a youngster, what did you learn at Bharatiya Vidya Bhavan in yoga? If you can tell us.
So it was a basic certificate course. So basic asanas and jalniti, and it was theoretical also. So basic posture, Surya Namaskar and Chakrasan and all the asana, Paschimottan, Sarvangasana. Yeah.
Okay, nice. Look at the way he sits like a yogi as well.
Yeah, actually, yes.
Such a beautiful posture, such a beautiful structured anatomical way of sitting, like so supportive. That's what I always say. Sorry to interrupt. That's what I always say, right? Like when you are slouching, you're doing disservice to your anatomy. But when you're sitting, lengthened spine, aligned spine, neck and head, you're actually honoring, you're stepping into your, you know, the way your anatomy has been designed. And it's designed in the most, I mean, our anatomy is one of the most superior, most evolved we know on the planet. So it's like we're really offering, you know, the service, the honor it receives when you're sitting tall, like a yogi, like Arjun.
Yeah, what a beautiful way of expressing it. Loved it. And you both can also ask questions to each other, since you can connect on a wavelength with yoga and spirituality. I'll keep the session open for both of you as well. And before that, Mansi, I would also like to know about, if you can tell us about your house of Kapali. You're a founder of Manastha also.
Manaste.
Manaste. Yeah, Manaste. Yes. So about that.
Of course. So I'm a serial soulpreneur. I love to create, you know, I love to create conscious businesses. You know, whether they survive or not, I then sometimes lose track of it. But for me, it's the process of creation. It's me accessing my yoni. It's me accessing that, you know, as women, we're blessed with this center of creation, right? So it's not just a place of birthing, but it's also a place where ideas are born, right? Where you put out your creative best into the world. So House of Kapali and Manaste are both outcomes of, you know, my yoni accessing its creative abilities. So House of Kapali, of course, it started out as a bed and breakfast. We were acknowledged, very humbled by that. We were acknowledged as the best B&B in India. Wow. By the government of India. But now it's evolved into a space of wellness. You know, so we do like transformation programs. We do wellness retreats, of course, because, you know, like the journey of your entrepreneurial journey is only a reflection or a resonance of what you are as an entrepreneur. So, you know, while I'm harnessing my own wellness journey, while I'm accessing my own spiritual journey, that's what my entrepreneurial journey will also reflect. So House of Kapali, Manaste, they're both outcomes of that. Manaste is a skincare brand. It's also a, you know, a soul wear brand. So like, you know, things like I wear like a, you know, it's a goddess-like ancient clothing and skincare, which is edible. So, you know, that's what we do in that, in Manaste. It's M with a Namaste. That's what it is. And Kapali now is also in Goa, is now also in the Himalayas. So we just got a beautiful property out in the middle of nowhere. You have to hike to it. It's paradise. It's absolute. Like, I can't wait to live there. It's ahead of Beer. So you have to visit Madhvi and Arjun.
Yes, you definitely. Look, sounds amazing. Sounds amazing. And would love to visit it for sure.
Yeah.
And now I would like to come to Arjun. That Arjun, you also joined Sivananda Vedanta. So if you can tell us that, what did you exactly learn at the Sivananda Vedanta?
Yeah, it was also a certificate course. It was a 1 week course, a basic course. So later on, my teacher told me to do the teacher training course as well. But I've been planning since then, but I did not get the chance. Next year, I will go probably and do the teacher training.
Beautiful.
Great. Wonderful. So what did you learn exactly there in that 1 week? If you can know.
Same asanas, pranayam, and Sivananda's Surya Namaskar.
Okay, great. And now this question goes to both of you, Mansi and Arjun, because I know, Mansi, you've also been part of the Osho Zorba the Buddha, and even Arjun has, attended the program over there. And if you can tell, what is the connection of spirituality and yoga?
Arjun, you go. Go ahead, Arjun.
It balances the mind, body, and breath, yoga. So there's a great connection with spirituality. And spirituality, I feel it is a way of living the life.
Okay, great. Yeah, because you also happen to be from Art of Living. So Art of Living, Osho, Zorba the Buddha, and yoga meditation. So I really want to know, what is the connection? Since Mansi, you also been associated with spirituality. So what is the connection between yoga and spirituality? Yes, Arjun, go ahead.
So they focus on only one thing. Everything is on breath only. Whether you go to Art of Living, Sudarshan Kriya, it's to do with breath, and even the Yogada Satsang, Hongsa technique, it is again with breath. So everything comes to the breath only.
Okay, so that's one connection between spirituality and yoga, is that it's all connected with the breath ultimately. So now Mansi would like to know
But Arjun said it all, because that's, you know, that's really, that's, he's, he hit the nail on the head. Because really, that's, you know, yoga and spirituality are absolutely inextricable from each other. You know, they're peas in a pod, they're born one out of each other, right? So it's like asking, it's like me asking, what's the connection between Madhvi and Arjun? They're inextricable. So, you know, one's born from the other, the other is born from the other. So, you know, they're really, that's what the connection
Beautiful.
Is. And like Arjun said, it's, you know, breath is our highest guide. It's, you know, it's that beautiful guru that's always resident within you. And it's true for yoga. It's true for spirituality. You know, spirituality is yoga. Yoga is spirituality. It's, there is no difference. These are just, you know, words we give. But what it is about at the end of the day is, it is, like Arjun said, it's a, you know, it's a bhava of your breath. It's your, it's you experiencing your prana, your vital life force. And that experience, that conscious experience of it is yoga, is spirituality, is life, really. You know, it's living. It's that's, if you can access that even for a moment in your day, even for a moment in your life, I think you are already an elevated being. And it's that's why it's, you know, this is my message that I give several times a day these days, you know, given the pandemic and everything, that please guys, do pranayama, do pranayama, do pranayama. But we can keep saying it, but what, you know, one has to really like come to it yourself. You have to feel the need from deep inside your heart saying that, okay, you know, I need to access that inner quiet. It's getting too loud, it's getting too busy. I need to, you know, just tap into that which is truly me, that which is my true power. And actually, it's not a feeble space. It's a very vibrant, conscious space. Right, Arjun? Because when you access that stillness, there's nothing dull about it. It's not like, you know, you're just like stupefied in a yogi-like state. You are energized, you're awakened, and you're full of so much vibrance as a life energy that, you know, that's what you're going to throw out into the world. That's what we were talking about, right? So this is the question I always ask, that do you want to, this is what, like, this is, yeah, this is quote Sadhguru. So do you want to be a conscious being, or do you want to be a constipated being? So you make the choice. I choose conscious.
So, I think very, very well and beautifully expressed by both of you. The definition could not have been better than how you both have expressed from your own experiences and your own, you know, journey in the yoga and meditation. So before, you know, before we go for the meditation and exercises, it would be really nice if we could, you know, the people can learn something out of it today as well. And there'll be some questions in between, but if we can start with some warm-up exercises, two warm-up by Arjun and then two by Mansi. So can we start with Arjun with the warm-up exercise and then take it further with you, Mansi?
Sure.
Yeah. So Arjun, if you can start with some two warm-up exercises.
Yeah, sure. So I will do the cat and cow pose.
Lovely. Excellent.
So you inhale, go up. It's cow pose. And you exhale, you go down. That's the cat pose. Stretch.
Yeah, next one. Because it is just a teaser for everyone to know what yoga is all about.
Your left hand and right leg.
Okay.
Stretch.
Beautiful.
Opposite.
good choice, Arjun. That's
lovely. So now we would like to come to Mansi with two stretching exercises for the audience which they can learn today.
Sure. Okay. So we're going to do, if everyone will come in a seated position, any comfortable seated position will do. Let me put this a little bit down so you can see my legs.
And you can do it along with her, Arjun.
Arjun, you must do it. Yes, correct.
Yeah.
Okay. Okay. So what we're going to do is put our hands on the knees. I call this the Sufi grinds, right? It's super nice to warm up the spine, to nourish the spine with this. So what we're going to start to do is we're going to start to rotate around the spine. What this is not is this. It's not this at all. What it is a very internal, subtle movement, right? So because we're awakening our very core, right? Right, the very center of us. So what we need to do is we need to be very active with this. And then we need to change to the other direction. And you need to have a good time while you do it. You can do this. The magic of this is that you can do it even when you're sitting on a chair. And if you're on the ground, that's fantastic. I don't think you can do it standing. I didn't try that yet, but I'll get back to you on that one.
Yeah, but it's like anti-clockwise and clockwise.
Sorry? Yeah, clockwise.
Anti-clockwise.
Very beautiful to energize the spine. Very nice to, you know, awaken the digestive organs as well as prepare the body for pranayama, for meditation. Very beautiful for both of that. Okay, the next one that we're doing today is, so like, I'm going to add, like Arjun showed us the proper cat-cow on the tabletop position. We can also do the cat-cow in the seated position, which is very versatile because you can do that again on a chair. You know, we spend so much of our times on a chair these days, on a desk. So this one gives you no excuses to not do it, right? So you don't keep sitting on the chair like Madhvi's like in front of a computer now. So you can still do it. And it's going to create so much exuberance in the spine. Super nice to just stretch it out. A few rounds of this, and then you inhale your arms up, take them all the way up. Imagine that there's a rainbow of energies around you. Inhale. Exhale. Just stretch the arms out. Inhale. Exhale. And this time, so you start to involve your neck, look up. Bring your hands to touch overhead and then slowly bring your forearms together and bring them all the way down. One more time. Inhale, look up, arms go up, hands come together. Bring your forearms to touch to your heart center and release. And what that does, just these two exercises, what that does is that it opens up all the parts that you use when you're sitting on a chair, your shoulders, your spine, your lumbar back, your glutes, and it just stretches it out. And your neck is going to feel relaxed also. So, I mean, just a little bit of versatility adding to what Arjun offered us as well.
There's a question from Mohsin Habib. He wants to know that, ma'am, kaise weight lose karein?
Khana kam kha lo yaar. No, it's again, it's like you have to watch what you're feeding into the body. Are you exercising a little bit? Because this is like, you know, this question is much more to do with common sense than a yogi's answer. You know, there's nothing Arjun and I can add to this, but you already know. Mohsin, you already know. Aapko kya karna hai, kya nahi karna hai. To aapko karo. Jo aapko pata hai. Your common sense already tells you what you need to do. Are you doing 30 minutes of exercise movement on a daily basis, non-negotiable? Are you doing some energizing pranayamas on a daily basis? Are you eating what's good for you? Are you eating processed foods, you know, foods that are excess in sugars? Or are you eating a predominantly plant-based whole foods diet, right? So you know which end of the spectrum you're lying in. Whatever you need to do, start. I mean, you know, the change doesn't happen in one giant leap. It doesn't happen overnight. It's not. You know, we're creatures of habit. So we respond best to small changes, small good habits that you can add. You know, if you're used to eating, you know, lots of junk food, can you reduce one packet? You know, can you reduce like two things from your daily
gradually.
Life and add two fruits? Can you add just one apple and one banana? Whatever fruits you like. Yeah, or even if you don't remove, can you just add the fruit? Can you just add a small portion of salad? So Mohsin, you already know what you need to do. Aap wo karo.
Well replied. And now Arjun, two breath exercises from you and also with Mansi later. Can you do two breath exercises?
Yeah, I will do Kapalbhati.
Lovely.
So close your eyes and breathe in gently. Breathe out. Now I'm just exhale.
Yeah, next.
This you should do 5 to 10 minutes daily.
Okay.
On an empty stomach.
Yeah, so, one more?
I will do Bhastrika. Okay.
Good. Nice. And now to Mansi also, what is the benefit of these breath exercises? If you can tell the audience about that as well.
Are you asking me?
Yeah.
Yeah. Okay, so both the ones that Arjun did right now, so you know we categorize pranayamas in three main categories. So both the ones that Arjun showed us just now, they're both energizing kind of pranayamas. So what they do is that they awaken the energies in the body, but also most importantly, they detoxify the body. So you notice the rhythm, the pace, they're quite pacey, right? They're very active, both of these. So both of those, they have to be practiced in the first half of the day. They have to be practiced preferably first thing in the morning. Because can you imagine the day that you will have if you are doing full power Bhastrika, you will have a very charged up day. So it's one of the best ways to step into your day using these energizing pranayamas that Arjun demonstrated so beautifully.
Wonderful.
The second kind of pranayama is tranquilizing. So they calm you. If you're feeling angry, you're feeling full of, you know, you're feeling out of sorts, you're feeling something's not right, you need a little bit of a tranquilizing pill. So just like we, you know, we pop a pill, like that's a tranquilizing pill. Pranayamas like Bhramri, you know, the buzzing sound, Omkara, they're tranquilizing for our energies, for our mind, body, emotions. You know, they balance us, they tranquilize, they put us in a state of calm.
Wow.
Third kind of pranayama is balancing, Nadi Shodhana, Anulom Vilom, Ujjayi, right? So these create a balance of our nadi. We have 72,000 energy channels in our body, right? So these kind of pranayamas balance the energy channels. So you'll come out with an equalized breath when your channels are balanced, when your breath is balanced, when your solar and your lunar aspects are balanced, you know, the masculine, the feminine aspects of us, the logical and the creative aspects of us, all of it comes in a beautiful bouquet of balance. And what we present to the world is then, of course, a very harmonious being, a very harmonious life energy. You know, we're not too much of the one thing or too less of the one thing. We're in a balance, right?
Beautiful. And if you can also tell two of these to the beginners who are just beginning to start with yoga.
Yes, let's do that. Okay, one of the most accessible breathing techniques and also one of the most powerful breathing techniques is what we call Samavriti. Yeah, equalized breath. And what we need to do in that is that just take your right hand, place it on your abdomen. And what we're going to just do is that we're going to inhale. Imagine there's a balloon in your abdomen. The balloon expands when you inhale and it releases as you exhale. So let's do this now. Inhale, close your eyes, align the spine. As you inhale, let the belly expand. as you exhale, exhale for the same proportion as the in-breath as you release the belly into the spine. I'm going to add a count. Inhale for 4, 3, 2, 1. Exhale for 4, 3, 2, 1. Making sure that you're expanding on the in-breath and exhaling, releasing on the out-breath. One more time. Inhale, expand into the belly. Your chest inflates, your shoulders lift up. 3, 2, 1. As you exhale, release and relax. 4, 3, 2, 1. Soak it in. Take a moment, slowly open your eyes. And you'll notice that, you know, it's not rocket science to create an energetic shift of energies within you. We are, it's so apparent, right? If you really tune into it, we are only energy, vibrations, and a particular frequency. So, you know, I always ask this question, do you want to, you know, you want to turn up your frequency or you want to lower down your frequency? It's up to you. It's all in your breath. The guidance is all in here. Great. So, yeah.
Lovely. Beautiful. Yeah, two of the relaxation exercises as well. Two to each relaxation. Yeah. How do we relax?
Yeah. So before we relax, this is my new favorite breathing technique that's been through the pandemic. It's not just very regenerative for the lungs, for the pulmonary, you know, functionality. It's also, it induces a quality of joy in our existence. So I want you guys to test it out, see if it works for you, and join me. So Madhvi, you need to join me as well, because you can do it seated on a chair, no problem. Arjun, you're going to join me, of course.
But can we just take this question? Mansi? So Meenakshi Mohanty is writing that I have lost my energy after COVID and have a major back issue. Though it's been 12 to 13 years, I'm practicing yoga. So any advice for her?
Arjun, go ahead.
I have lost my energy after COVID and have managed and have major actually back issues.
Yeah.
Though it's been 12, 13 years that I've been practicing yoga.
I would say Arjun, just listen to your body. I would say just listen to your body and start whatever. Don't force it. And how much you can do that only. Don't stretch too much. Whichever is comfortable for your body, you should always listen to your body. I would suggest that.
Mansi, can you advise her on that?
Arjun is so wise and, you know, just so few words. He puts so much wisdom in. So it's really, but that's exactly what I would, you know, I would very much resonate with what Arjun is saying, that, you know, if you've been doing yoga, you've been doing yoga for like almost a decade and a half, you feel like, oh, you should be able to do all your asanas. But, you know, this is not the time to be so demanding on your body. Your body's gone through a lot of trauma, your emotions, the stress levels, everything's gone through a lot of trauma. This is the time to focus on the healing, the slowness. This is a time for you to just focus on your pranayama. This is the time to come back to your meditation practice. Maybe this is not the time for outward movement. It's a time for inward journeys. So, you know, just think about that for your back problems, for your backache. What you need to do is, like Arjun showed us, do your cat-cow practice, do bhujangasana. You know, this practice this twice or thrice a day with like lots of long holds, and your back will naturally come into its natural rhythm, because you are having a backache, not because of COVID or anything else. You're having it because of the emotional trauma you've gone through. You're having it, you know, in our lumbar spine, in our hips, all our unprocessed emotions come and settle. So back pain, especially lumbar pain, is directly to do with the stress levels that you have been through. So it's important that you don't focus on that. Don't put all your energies on your lumbar back. It's just coming from a place of stress. In fact, the one time, let me tell you from my experience, and don't laugh, guys. The one time that I had COVID last year, I got a back pain that I've never experienced back pain in my whole entire life. And then I got this back pain. I really didn't know what to do with it. I didn't know who to talk to because, you know, like I offer people suggestions and, you know, solutions for back pain. So I'm just like, what is this? And then, you know, once I went to Goa and I forgot about, like, I just, you know, I got occupied with other things. And then my cousin had a trampoline in her home and we were just bouncing on the trampoline. And that was the last day I experienced that back pain. So what was her name?
Mohanty, she's, yeah.
Yeah. So I would highly recommend that you go to, you know, you like access a trampoline if you have, whenever you do, and just jump on it and jump your troubles away. And then I think it's all going to go.
I think it's very, very well replied, both of you. Like, definitely, you should not focus only on your illness and probably start devoting time and energies elsewhere. And also, Arjun rightly said that take it easy. I think time take its own time rather than rushing or hurrying into it. Because I think she's been a really big yoga freak from last 12, 13 years. So it is natural to feel like that, that you're not able to do the same kind of exercises that you were able to do earlier. But I'm sure she'll be able to do. So I think just give it some more time.
Like what Manti said, focus on more pranayam and inner rather than doing more asanas. And
yeah, focus on the inner rather than the outer. You know, it's just in. Maybe everything in your life and your experience is telling you, bring it home. It's time to bring it home. I call it, do your own work. Do your own work. Are you guys doing your own work?
Yeah, that's Meenakshi, Mohanty. Thank you, Arjun and Manti.
Meenakshi, yes. Good, great.
So, Manti, we'll come to this only now, that if you can teach some of the relaxation exercises, two of them each to both of you, so that people who are beginners and who have not been practicing yoga may start practicing after seeing this by both of you.
Great. Go ahead, Arjun.
So it's tensing and relaxing. So you tense your whole body. Inhale and tense, and then you exhale and relax. So double breath inhalation. Third time you do it without tension.
Another one? One more.
Okay. You raise your hand in double inhalation. It's actually better when you do when you stand up and do it. I actually prefer standing and then doing it. It's much better.
So would you like to show standing and doing it?
Yeah, it's quite same. So you tense your neck also. Let me just switch on the light.
That's okay, we can see Arjun, don't worry.
Yeah, now it's better.
Yeah.
Similarly, you can do sideways. Yeah.
Great. Fabulous. Wonderful.
Amazing. Yeah. That's so fantastic.
I wish I had started that early. I'm really feeling I'm too late to start.
he's on such a beautiful path. So, so happy. It warms my heart. Wonderful. Very, very, very nice, Arjun.
Yeah, Mansi, can you also please teach us?
Sure. Because now Arjun has shown us very energizing ones. I'm also feeling full of energy. I need to show you something which is in the same spirit. Okay, so this is what I call yawn to smile, right? So everyone knows how to yawn. This is what we need to do. Watch, don't do anything yet. Guys, just take a big yawn. Spread your arms 60 degrees. Open your mouth. Take a big inhalation like this. As you exhale, you're going to bring your hands down. Exhale through the nostrils and smile. 3, 2, 1. Okay, I'm going to show you one more time. Then we're going to do it a few times together like this. Okay, let's do this together. You need to take a big yawn. And then when you exhale, smile for 3 seconds. I'm counting so you cannot cheat. Okay. And the other thing with this is you can have your eyes open or closed. It's, you know, it's easy. Let's do it. Inhale, open, big yawn. Arjun, join me. Madhvi, join me. Look up. Fill yourself with air. Exhale down. 3, 2, smile. 1. Arjun, haath niche karo. Inhale, up. Fill yourself up with beautiful oxygen. As you exhale, the hands down. Smile. 3, 2, 1. More stretch. Bigger stretch. Open up. Exhale down. 3. Smile. 2. Smile. 1. One more. Inhale. Stretch it out. Exhale. Hands down. Smile for 3, 2, 1. Close your eyes for a moment here. And just feel the little bubbles of joy and bliss that are emanating through you. They're always there. You just need to access them. And when you access them, you bring them to the full frontal of your energies. And that's how you start to create that ambiance around you. That's what's going to define the ambiance around you. Slowly open your eyes. One more? Or is it enough?
I think you can do it. One more.
One more, very quick one, a super fun one. What this does is that it opens up the heart space. Obviously, we know within our rib cage is also our lungs, our heart, you know, beautiful organs of vitality are right here. So we're going to tap and open it up. Tapping is a very, you know, it's a very important way that we can really remove stagnant energy from particular parts of the body where we focus the tapping. This is how we tap. We make a little fist. We use our knuckles to tap the heart space open, okay? So you have to do it like you mean it. You have to channel your inner chimpanzee, okay? Because that's, they are our ancestors, right? So it shouldn't be too hard for you or me, everyone. Okay, so this is how we're going to do it. Watch. We're going to start tapping to the left, exactly where the heart is, and then to the right. Join me. You're using the knuckle, the first knuckle of your fingers to tap, and you're not beating yourself up. It's a nice, gentle tap. You are awakening the heart. You are telling the heart, okay, come on, open your doors. I'm ready, right? So let's go. Tap, 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 tap. Keep breathing. Keep breathing. Yes. Keep moving through. Close your eyes and just notice all the areas that feel a little tight and where you're able to offer energization, where you're able to offer movement of energy under the shoulders, collarbone. Yes. And then now bring your focus just to the heart center, just a little bit towards the left. Keep tapping slow and release the hands down. Close your eyes and feel the activation. You've just removed a whole bunch of stagnancy around the heart space, around your Anahata chakra. This is also the place where our loving kindness lives, where our compassion lives. You've unleashed all of these beautiful qualities. And feel this vibration, feel the reverberation in your chest, in your heart, knowing that you've removed some of that stagnant energy, the energy of conditioning, the energy of fears, inhibition, removing that, entering into a space of love, acceptance, compassion, karuna, metta. Slowly open your eyes with a beautiful smile on your face.
Lovely.
Yeah, just, you know, it takes awesome. That. It doesn't take much, right? These are simple things. Like even That's the right. stuff I showed us. Like I loved it. It's you know, it's very energizing. You feel like you come alive in under 30 seconds. You feel like wow. It's like you know, you really create a shift in your day.
Good to go. That's right. Good to Absolutely.
Go. Yeah, you're good to go. Exactly.
Yeah.
Or you're
no,
good
wonderful.
To stay. You're good to yeah. stay.
Also. yeah. Before we come to the couple of questions, I think last but not the least, I would like Arjun to do some meditation, and we'll you know, close this with the laughter therapy, laughter yoga by Mansi. Laughter, after you, yes. Arjun is done with the meditation technique.
Done. Sure.
And then we'll just in the end take a few questions as well. Yeah, Arjun, for meditation.
Yeah, so I'm going to do the Hongsa technique. Make sure your back is straight. So like we did earlier, tensing and relaxing. We'll do that 3 times. Third time without tension. So tense, double inhalation. So now we'll do 20 counts breathe in and 20 counts hold, 20 counts breathe out. We'll do this 6 times. So breathe in. Hold. And breathe out. Hold 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Breathe out. In your own rhythm, do it 5 more times.
Great. Wonderful. I think the audience is loving the program, and a lot of compliments both of you are getting. There's a question from Rajesh Sehgal. What do you suggest for senior citizens? How they can be benefited with simple yoga asana? Mansi?
For them, what they need to do is really just simple stretching. You know, it depends now how senior, because they, you know, like, if it's a senior citizen like my dad, you know, he'll run a marathon. So it really depends, you know, but what's always beneficial is joint mobility. You know, we do Sushumna Pranayama, we do Sushumna Yoga, which is like movement, moving the joints, moving each and every joint, ankles, from the top of your head all the way down to your feet. You focus on joint movement. And another aspect you focus on for people who are like over 60, I mean, it's not, they're nothing senior about them, you know, is overall stretching. So, you know, take your hands and stretch it all the way, Tadasana, super beautiful. That's what they need to do. And then this is really a time where you encourage them, if they can, they must walk. That's one of the healthiest things they need to do. They don't need to contort their body in all kinds of shapes and sizes. What they need to do is, you know, just walk, connect with the earth and connect with their breath. So encourage them to breathe, take deep, long, healing breaths, do as much pranayama, you know, if they can. If they're, you know, much older, then they should really be, you know, dedicating a predominant part of their day to pranayama, to meditation, to dhyan, really, you know, because
that's, lovely. You know, I think we've got the reply. And right now, I think laughter is the call of the hour. We've all been going through really, really tough times in the pandemic. So if we can laugh a little with you, Mansi, and you can teach them the laughter yoga.
Done. Let's do it. So this is only for a few seconds. And I always say that, you know, laughter, because it's elusive, right? When we were young, we used to laugh and smile 600 times a day. And now under 10, that's like a really bad score, right? So we need to improve that. And that all will begin once we start to take ourselves a little less seriously. You know, we're so serious and grumpy all the time. What are people going to say? What's going to happen? What if I say this? And what's he going to say? What's she going to say? So we need to come out, like take yourself out of that whole roadmap of that, you know, that you've constructed around you, this whole barricading that you've constructed, and start to make yourself a little silly. Be a little silly, guys, please, I beg you. So what's going to happen is that you're going to laugh at yourself, you're going to create a lightness around you, and that's the energy you will present to the world in your, you know, immediate surroundings. So here we go. This is what we're going to do. Bring your arms up. Good. Now, inhale and hold your breath like we did in the yawn, right? So inhale and hold your breath. Hold your breath. Hold your breath. Hold your breath. Keep your eyes open. And when you can't hold the breath, go 1, 2, 3.
Wait.
Take a deep inhale, close your eyes, just soak it in. Soak in the healing and repair that comes from laughter. True. This is the best kind of healing, best kind of medicine, right? We've heard this.
So and it's much needed and required at this time, I think.
Much needed, so much needed, really.
And Mansi, a lot of people are also going through anxiety, depression around this time, you know. So any suggestion for them or any yoga for them that you suggest?
Yeah, you know, it's just when we're going through stress and anxiety, we tend to ignore ourselves, right? We tend to brush away our needs and we tend to, you know, feel a little like out of sorts, like I was saying. But this is really the time to be a bit more kinder to yourself, to be a bit more compassionate. Like Arjun was saying earlier to that question, right? This is like, take it easy. Don't push yourself, right? So do things that nourish your soul. Tune into it. You know, when you do a particular something, how did it feel for you? Can you walk, you know, barefoot in the morning dew on the grass? Can you do that? Can you access, you know, can you walk under the open sky, be with nature? Because that is what will heal you. Nature will heal you. You know, listen to your favorite songs that you used to enjoy, that you haven't enjoyed in a long time, and move a little, shake it out a little bit. Even if you have to force it, I always say, stuff that like makes you happy, you know it works for you, but it's not working for you now, force it. And then you'll see, you'll snap out of it. Because we get stuck so much in that loop, you have to like really sometimes, you know, you have to snap yourself out of it. So you have to force yourself to like move. You have to, you know, if you had to force yourself to laugh, but in the end, you'll feel good. So, you know, tune into that energy of things that are nourishing for your soul. That is what you need right now. And it's very essential that each one of us reaches deep into the very heart of us and nourishes our being, because we need this. You know, we as a generation of people, we've gone through a major trauma.
True.
We've gone through a turbulent time we never imagined that we would. So we all need to heal each other. We need to support each other. We need to like really like, you know, if you can lend out a helping hand, you know, don't question or judge people for what they're doing. They're doing the very best they can given the tools they have at the time. So help out, help yourself out. And, you know, together we can make it a beautiful, radiant world again. It will be.
Great. Wonderful. A lot of people are writing comments. I can see Vicky, Hanumant, Vinakshi, they're all appreciating, and thanks to both of you. And comments are there, which we can see later. So So just two, three questions more before we close. Great show, Mansi and Arjun. Thanks for your able guidance. Cheers, HD by Hanuman Talwar.
And
so basic question which I would like to ask you, Mansi, that a lot of people have complaints of headache, stomachache, and sleep disorder. So what do you advise to them? If Arjun, you also can, you know, ask any question you want to ask to Mansi, you can feel free as well.
So, you know, you said headache, migraine, sleep issues. Okay, all of this, Bhramri Pranayama is such a beautiful key that will unlock these issues. Because it creates, you know, it activates your vagus nerve, which is your message going from your brain to your gut. What it does is that it switches on your, you know, parasympathetic nervous system, your response to calm down. It vasculates, it opens up the capillaries wherever there is constriction. So what does a Disprin do? When you take a Disprin, it will go into that place. It will thin your blood in that place, right? Because blood flow is not happening. This is the very same thing that Bhramri has the effect on. Do you know that these blood thinners were designed on the basis of some of the pranayama techniques? So don't need to pop a pill. Do Bhramri. It will work with no side effects. So
and how do you do that?
Sorry?
How does one do that?
Yeah, let me show you one round of it. So you inhale through the nostrils, and when you exhale, you reverberate this humming sound that comes in through your chest, through your stomach, chest, and throat, like this. Inhale. So you'll see, you'll come into an instantly calming state. It's, you know, when you're in a calm state of mind, obviously, like, you know, you've created oxygen and blood supply into places where you were feeling the pain, the headache, even for stomach. And this is beautiful because it's a tranquilizing category of pranayamas. This is beautiful to induce you into a long, beautiful, deep sleep also. So you talked about sleep.
Right. Okay. So for both, it works for both. So we have the reply to
both. Yes, it works for both. Yeah.
Great. Wonderful.
It also raises the vibration. The vibration is so strong when you hum. The whole body gets energized.
The whole body can respond to it. So true.
You have any question to ask Arjun from Mansi?
He knows everything.
It's not really a question, but I have seen those videos, you know, in where dog is also doing yoga with the other person. So how to bring your dog into practice? How to bring your pet to do yoga with you?
How to bring your dog to do yoga with you?
Yeah.
He's seen a video. He's saying he's seen a video where a person is doing yoga with the pet.
Not one video. I have, in fact, seen quite a few videos.
Quite a few of them.
Dog is doing. Dog is also bringing his own mat and.
Oh, sweet! That's cute.
I tell you, us humans know no limits to the extents we can go sometimes.
Imagination is like, you know, it's like too much, tremendous. There's no limit to it.
I mean, but you know what what I want to say is that everything that we do, you know, the movements, Arjun, the asanas that we do in yoga, everything, you know this, everything is derived from nature. Right, we do the tree pose, we do all the animal poses, right? So everything we do in yoga, the shapes we make in the asana bit of it, is all derived from nature. We do the swana kriya. What is that swana kriya? It's the dog panting breath. So we imitate our animals. We do the cat cow, right? Everything is animals. So do you think we need to learn from them or we need to teach them? I think we need to do whatever they're doing. If they're like passed out sleeping, we need to do this.
Relax like that. Yeah.
They're far superior. You know, nature has beautiful intelligence. So we need to just have it quick rather than wanting the intelligence of the nature, you know, to like be curtailed because that's what we thought is the best solution. No. Let nature be wild.
And as you know, the program is about MadhuriesLuxury.co. I would like to know the definition of luxury from both of you, Mansi and Arjun. To you, yeah. Mansi.
Arjun, you go ahead.
Okay.
Luxury for me is just being happy. Even if you don't have a lot of cars, and even if you are not materialistic, but you are happy from inside, that luxury.
Contentment. Very good. Very nice.
Beautiful. Beautiful.
Mansi.
I think luxury for me is the present of this moment, the presence, the here and now, and that's luxury. If you are in this moment, it's a luxurious moment. If you're luxury. Not in this moment, there's no luxury in the world that could be as luxurious, you know, as you can make it for yourself. So I think, you know, just being here, being in this moment is the ultimate luxury.
Beautiful. Lovely. We don't need any materialistic things to be happy, basically. It's in the moment, right now, where you are. Lovely.
And from there, like that comes happiness. You know, if you're present in the yeah. moment, happiness will come, joy will come, bliss will come. You know, so many beautiful states will come. But if you're not here, in the present, in the here and now, it doesn't even matter. You can have all the accumulation of the world, but true. What is it? Because you're not even there.
Very, very well expressed and said. And the last question to you, Mansi, a message to the youngsters like Arjun who want to get into yoga, your advice to them.
But see, Arjun is an exception. Arjun is not, he doesn't define the generation as a whole. The generation as a whole is a whole lot different, you know, and that is, you know, that's a little bit question worthy in lots of ways. But my advice to Arjun is that keep at it. You know, you're on such a beautiful path of self-discovery, you know, of gaining that inner intelligence. This, you know, you're already on this inner journey, which like Madhvi, you said so beautifully that we didn't have access to this when we were absolutely. So young, right? So you're already on the path, Arjun. Keep at it. Just stick to it. Just, you know, keep like you. I have a feeling you're going to be a great yogi one day. You already are.
Thank you so much, Mansi. It's been a real pleasure hosting Arjun and Mansi here with us. Real honor. Thank you so much, Mansi. Thank you.
Thank you all. Been wonderful. Been absolutely joyous mm-hmm. to have this conversation with Arjun and Madhvi. Hope to connect in person soon.
Yes, very soon.
Some flowers your way. That's for you.
Thank you. Thank you. I accept it. Thank you.
Take care,
thanks.
Everyone.
Have a great evening and a great life.
Yes.
Bye-bye.
Happy yoga day.
Bye. For all those who missed the show, can watch it on my YouTube. For any queries related to real estate, art, hospitality, weddings, fashion designers, jewelry designers, health, wellness, and beauty, you can get in touch with madhuriesluxury.co. Thank you for being here and being a great audience as always. We are coming up with every day with amazing programs till Monday. International Yoga Day is on Monday. So tomorrow is Father's Day. We're going to celebrate Father's Day here and then on Monday, International Yoga Day. See you guys. Bye-bye. Have a great evening.